Hey, good news. We're here with another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Today, we're going to be joined by Jason and Sudha, where we're going to be talking about machine learning specific assessments. So join us. Welcome to the Azure Enablement Show, where we'll be discussing the challenges you and our other tech-savvy customers have encountered. Together, we'll be talking with experts to find out how they think about these problems, recommended tools and best practices, and tips they've learned from years of experience that you can use. Today, we're going to be talking about machine learning assessments. So I think the best thing for me to do is to switch to customer mode. Okay, well, here I am as a customer, and now I have the chance to talk to Jason and Sudha. Hey, Jason and Sudha, thanks so much for getting on a call with me. I really appreciate it.
Hey, David.
Hey, David.
So here's my problem. I'm wondering if you can help me with this. So we are just getting started in deploying some machine learning workloads onto Azure, and this is kind of our first time doing this, and I want to make sure we get things right. We've been trying to read the documentation, but there's a lot of documentation. I don't really know where to start. Do either of you have any suggestions on what I should be doing?
Of course, David. Microsoft provides all sorts of guidance for these type of issues, you know. So we are looking at customers like you to figure out like how to have a best journey in cloud. You know, you have to have avoid these costly pitfalls, improve your operational excellence, the reliability of your system, the performance, and be secured with your workload. And we are bringing this thing called Well-Architected Framework, which addresses all these considerations across the five pillars that I talked about. And it, more importantly, this is like a self-service tool. You know, the customers can actually go to our public doc site and they can do the assessments and they can find out the recommendations that come out of that. And, you know, and these are workload specific as well. I mean, we have one for Azure Machine Learning with the data being exploding and everybody wants to get insights from the data. Azure Machine Learning is one of our key service and we are providing this workload specific assessments that help the customer. I think you are aware of these WAF assessments, right? Like,
yeah, so I've definitely heard of the Well-Architected Framework, and I've definitely done those assessments, that thing where you sort of go on to a website and it asks you a bunch of questions about, you know, with the things you said, security, reliability, performance, cost. I remember we had to answer. There's five of these things. But I guess the thing that I don't really quite understand is I did that for workloads in general. Like, what's a workload specific assessment? What's like special about ML assessments?
Yeah, that's a great question, David. Yes, this is a new thing that we are bringing on top of the existing assessments, which is more general, like Azure platform assessment. Now we are bringing like workload specific. So what that means is, you can go and look at Azure Machine Learning specific questions. Like, for instance, you're thinking more about MLOps capability, or you're thinking more about how do I save costs using the Azure Machine Learning service, or, hey, I want to incorporate like responsible AI practices. Like, how do I get guidance for all these specific workload questions? We have the Well-Architected Framework workload specific assessments that will give all these, you know, recommendations for you. That is then, and then you can actually cater them to your requirements, right? Like, we have like about 80 plus recommendations that we have compiled into these five pillars. But the best thing is, not all of them, of course, will be relevant for you, but you can pick and choose like which one is the most suitable for your architecture, your environment. And these are curated guidance coming from Microsoft recommendations that will help you get your workload performant. You know, isn't that cool?
Yeah, I like the idea, but like, so now my head is really deep into the ML space right now. Like, I'm working on it right now. What are some of the things that are specific to machine learning that I would expect in an assessment, like that it didn't do before when it was just doing the regular assessments?
You want me to jump in here and answer this one, Sudha?
Yeah, of course, Jason.
Awesome. So, David, let's think about what's specific about machine learning workloads. And there's a few things, but maybe the most obvious is that we have a training phase and we have a kind of using phase, or, you know, that time when we're doing inferencing, where we're actually using our model, right? And that's kind of two very distinct steps to take in your application architecture, two very distinct things. So when we're doing an assessment about your application, we're going to start asking you if you've considered security for your training session. Have you considered security? Have you considered performance optimization for your inference phase of things, right? And those are going to be different. So think about, for instance, our training. We often don't need that to be near real time, right? So when it comes to that cost optimization, you may not need the most real-time, most instant response. Instead, you might be able to take advantage of things like spot instances. You might even be able to scale down. Now, of course, you're also working with giant data sets when you're doing training, so there's some trade-offs there. Security also can be a little different when you're thinking about your training phase, because often you can do that entire step inside your network, basically completely firewalled off in the same way that all of your internal communications are. That doesn't need to be exposed to the world. Contrarily, your inference timer, when you're using your model, maybe that model is being used via an API from a mobile application for your customers, or maybe just directly from a website. Now, in that case, we may want that to be near real-time performance. So it's a different set of considerations. And of course, now it's exposed to the internet. So security considerations are different. So as we go through and ask you about those considerations, they're going to be targeted. The questions and the recommendations that we're going to give you based on your answers will be targeted to those different phases. Unlike, say, if we were asking you about a web app or your database. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes total sense. So now I kind of understand the questions I'm going to be asked and how they apply to my workloads. What's the payoff here? What sort of recommendations are am I going to see? Like presumably other people have done this before. You must know what other customers get for recommendations. What would you expect the sort of things I would probably see as just someone running machine learning workloads?
Yeah, I can answer that, Jason, here. Like, David, we have run these assessments with several customers, and they are very, like you, right? Like, you know, they are very generally interested more on enterprise readiness, like what Jason talked about, right? Like, they want to make sure their workload is very secure, their data is encrypted, they have the relevant private endpoints, you know, things like that. And the key hot topic they're worried about is MLOps, right? Like, this is like big transformation for them, bringing their data scientists and the IT engineers. How do they make this machine learning models work well with the kind of the data geeks with the IT landscape, right? Like, so that is a key thing. Those type of guidances are important. And the other important thing that customers like you are interested are more on the model maintenance best practices, right? Like, you know, how do they understand drift in the model? How can they retrain the model? How can the inferencing that Jason talked about can be real time without much of like the downtime of retraining, like with data changes, right? And responsible AI, this is really picking up like a huge hot topic these days, like because they want to know the transparency of the AI models, fairness, like inclusiveness, and all these aspects of responsible AI. So those are some of the key topics. And the last but not the least is the compute, right? Like the cost. That's the main thing, like what Jason talked about, like, you know, the training and the inferencing. And they always have this guidance, like, okay, how do I train my model? How can I lower my cost? How do I inference? It could be a deep learning or a machine learning model. It can be different type of inferencing needs you need. And these type of guidances are super critical for them. And this is the relevant recommendations that we are seeing, like most often, like asked by these customers, right? Like you. So, yeah.
Okay. So that's cool. So I guess I'm getting a really good sense of what I have to do now. The thing I'm kind of curious about is like this assessment's new to me. Like I took the other assessment, but this wasn't available when I was first doing assessments. So that says to me that like this is coming on board, and this is like the first version of it. What more am I going to expect to be showing up in assessments like these?
Oh, yeah, of course. I mean, David, we are always interested in bringing more to the customers, right? That's just our job here. So first off, like, you know, these assessments are kept evergreen, right? Like when the product changes, product cycle changes, the AML assessments will be updated to include the new features for the customers. The other thing is, like, these are like assessments that are questionnaires that brings you like a concept of how do you define your architecture, maybe your existing architecture, it brings you different recommendations. We are also adding what is called as advisor signals, which are basically like, think about them like a consultant for you, like a service consultant, you know, which is available to you all the time at your service, right? So what this does is it's really like it's a service on top of Azure. It provides you health recommendations about your service, right? In terms of cost, hey, you didn't shut down that VM, right? Or, you know, that was, this particular endpoint is not secured. Things like that, that come to you with your subscription, and that's a next edition of AML. And we are also continuously improving and adding more workload-specific assessments, right? Like you can expect to see the other AI ML services like Cox services, the Cox search, all of them are cooking, and it'll be coming to the customer very soon. And those are something that you can expect to see in the future.
Cool. Well, let me ask the kind of obvious question. Now that you've got, you've definitely piqued my interest, and now I have a sense of what's available here. What should I like do next?
Jason, you want to answer that question for David?
Yeah, by all means. I think what you want to do is head over to our assessments website and make the appropriate selection to say that the workload that you're interested in is right now, of course, your ML workload. And that's going to kick off everything we've just talked about here for your application.
Cool. Well, I think I'm going to go do that. And I think with that, I'm going to come out of customer mode. So thank you both. I really appreciate your help. Let me go back to being a host. Okay, I'm back as a host. Well, I just want to thank Sudha and Jason for being on the show. And I want to thank all of you for watching. I hope that helped you and will be useful to you in the future. So please join us again on more episodes of the Azure Enablement Show.